What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the spot where we kick back and react to all kind of different things. All right, so what we got going on today? We're jumping into another Dak song. This one's called Suffocating, official music video. So looks like this is going to be one of the more serious ones where he gets really deep. So not one of the more crazy ones where he's going crazy with the bars and got to throw a few dick bars in wherever he can squeeze them in. Cause I love that for all the crazy bars he puts in there, but man, you be forcing the dick bars sometimes, man. But it's all cool, you know. You still kill it every time anyway. It don't even matter. But anyway, this has got the kind of title that makes you feel like it's going to get deep. So let's go ahead and get into this. But before we do, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, what are you waiting for? It costs you absolutely nothing, and it keeps you up on all the new videos that get dropped on this channel. Not to mention, it gets us one step closer to that goal we're trying to reach, trying to get to 1,000 subs by the end of the year. We are super close, all right? So if you have not subscribed yet, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, and become an official supporter of the channel, all right? So let's go and get into this. Dax, Suffocating, the official music video. Let's go.
Number one album in the world. I told you to trust me, and now we got it. Dax, you're probably out celebrating right now. Give me a call when you can. We have to get that contract signed. You don't have to read it. I've gone over everything. And remember, for tonight at the talk show, keep it light, keep it positive. Nobody wants to hear anything negative and this sad shit. Your life is about to be changed, brother. I'll talk to you soon. Sign that.
Damn, he's sitting there with a whole bunch of knives in his back and everything. Yep. I had a feeling it's going in this direction.
Soon. Sign that contract.
First I couldn't breathe, now I'm suffocating. Maybe the pressure from the fame isn't worth what I'm chasing.
I don't know.
I used to say God's playing, now the devil's on my team acting foul and it's all flagrant. Trying to push me off the path that I'm steady paving. Sin is the currency and every day I'm making payments. I don't want to live in it, but I heard a saying, good knows evil because the houses are both adjacent. I don't know if I should go for these goals. I've seen people gain the world but lose their souls. My anxiety is building as the weight of it grows. I seclude myself in privacy inside my home, and I barely answer calls, and when I see my phone, I'm reminded that the real feeling of being alone is having millions who love you but can leave you, or say that they hate you at the moment they don't fuck with a song. I used to laugh it off.
Ain't that the truth, man? I see it happen all the time. It's a lot of pressure when you're a creator, because it's like, when you on fire, everybody on it. But the moment you do something that ain't hitting. I've seen it happen over and over with different artists. They always talk about people make it when they make a comeback and everything. And it's like, did they really make a comeback? Or were you just, you know, you just going a little overboard over the fact that their last joint wasn't hitting the way you thought it would be hitting? You know? It's kind of cold when you think about it. On the creator side, it's kind of cold because then you got the stress of, I always got to outdo myself, because if I can't outdo myself, then I become trash. Sucks sometimes. But yeah, totally feel what are you talking about here, man.
You at the moment, they don't fuck with a song. I used to laugh it off. Now I hold my breath and suffocate. Then I sit and wait just to see if I can kill the hate. And as I'm fleeting, I see God at the heaven's gates and come back down to fight another day. Then I grab that same phone and smile and wave and pour my empty heart into a song that they won't praise. They say patience is the key, but they didn't tell me. While I wait, I'd be locked inside a steel cage. Something's wrong. I feel claustrophobic. I'm stuck living in the past and not the moment, or the future where my life is only more broken, cause those wounds from the past are still open. I take sips of love and every single time it's poison. I see women who can't see past my employment or see me.
And she got the succubus shadow going on in the background. See? Over here, he talking some real talk right here. Yeah, be careful trying to sip love here and there, and it all came out as poison. None of it was sweet. You better be careful, man.
It's only more broken, cause those wounds from the past are still open. I take sips of love and every single time it's poison. I see women who can't see past my employment or see me as enjoyment, so I can't enjoy it cause the ride's temporary and they leave once they crash and destroy it. I don't think this life is healthy. Why didn't anybody?
So they don't need you no more. They out. They out. See, you gotta be careful, man, with them ones. Try to find you a real one. Gotta be careful because snakes are everywhere.
Leave once they crash and destroy it. I don't think this life is healthy. Why didn't anybody tell me? Everybody'd want help, but nobody wanna help me. I'm an ATM, a therapist, and everybody's friendly. And they hide their real intentions, but my mind won't let me. If I make a sad song, don't ask me if I'm happy. Fuck a hook, my pain isn't catchy. If you relate or worse, feel badly. Fucking pity me at least and check in if you at me. That's the only way I know who it touches. That's why I stay awake and answer DMs by the hundreds, so I don't lose myself and fill my stomach with the feeling that I'm here just to suffocate for nothing. If you know real pain, then you see it when you look me in my eyes. I try to hide it, but they do not lie. I wanna sleep, but if I try, the demons will creep and my dreams will collide. So I stay up and I stare at the ceiling and ask myself if I should even share these feelings. Then I hear a voice in the distance from a ghost-like image say my pain could be somebody's healing. So I close my eyes and drift to the place that inspires these lyrics. And as I see flames and I scream, I pray it's a place you'll never have to visit.
Man, I knew he was going to go deep on this one. Talking about his personal pain, man. Suffocating. What can happen when you get too big too fast, as I like to put it. Too big too fast. The walls start closing in on you because the fame is demanding. It demands a lot. A lot of energy, a lot of time. And again, you got to swim through all the sharks that are coming at you the entire way. So, stress levels, I can imagine. Another good one on the books for Dax. I wonder how, when this one actually came out, though. Was this like a year or 2 years ago? Y'all let me know in the comments. But, alright, y'all know what to do. Go down in the comment section, let me know what y'all thought about this one. And also let me know what you'd like to see me react to next. Hit that like button before you go. Share this video with everyone you know. And subscribe if you haven't done so already. Alright, so, till next time, take care of yourselves. And I'm out of here.